Hi folks and welcome to All Things Photography. As you can see, we're coming up to Christmas, so I just wanted to take time to show you one of my favourite toys or gadgets that I bought this year, and I've been using it a fair bit since about June when I bought it. And it is the Feiyu Tech G3 Ultra handheld steady gimbal. And this is for use with the GoPros from the GoPro 3, 3 Plus onwards and the GoPro 4. Now, if you haven't seen these before, they're brilliant. If you use GoPros for motion graphics, as in not statically locked down on a tripod, if you're carrying the GoPro about while filming, now this is something you might want to look at. It's absolutely brilliant, works very, very well, and it makes the footage from your GoPro absolutely outstanding, really, really steady. Now I'll show you what you get in the box. There's a couple of bits and pieces. Now this cost at the time of filming something like £210, I think it was, and it's ready to go straight out of the box. So I'll put a link on here to the full review on All Things Photography. Now what you get in the box, the normal charging bits and pieces. Now I've left the actual battery charger in the office, but you get all the different bits and pieces, meaning you can charge it through, you can charge the batteries with the battery holder via either your computer or via a plug into the wall. So you get various options and it's very quick and easy to charge, so I won't go on too much about that. Another thing you get in here is the USB cable. Now this again is for charging, but you also get this here USB dongle. Now this is quite important because this is for updating the firmware on the gimbal. I've had to update it once since May or June last year or this year, and it's just to, if they have any defects, if they notice anything wrong, or if they need to update the gimbal itself, you'll get a notification if you register with Feiyu Tech, and then you just follow the instructions. Now I will say there's a couple of really good online tutorials to show you how to update this, and I would watch them. The instructions are fairly good from Feiyu Tech, but if there's a couple of people online that have actually shown you how to do this, I would do it. It's very important to follow it absolutely to the T, because if you mess up anywhere along the way, you can actually mess up the firmware in the gimbal. So make sure you read up on that before you do any firmware updates. If you're unsure, just like I say, look online or contact Feiyu Tech themselves. But that's the USB dongle there. Now the gimbal comes with four batteries. It only takes three, but it comes with four. These small, I think they're 3.7 volts, 650 mAh batteries. So you get four of them, so you always get a spare. So don't know why they do that. And the actual charger only takes three as well, so it's a bit strange. Now what we've got in here then is the actual gimbal itself. So if I take this out of the packaging, that's it there. So you can see it's pretty neat. Now, one thing I will say about this gimbal as opposed to others are the wires are on the outside. Nothing much to worry about, because basically you've got a stopper on here that will stop it going too far, allowing the wires to get wrapped around. So don't even think about that. It works very well. I've never had any issues with it at all. And this is a three-way axis gimbal. It's much like the ones you get on drones, the modern ones you get on the drones. So it will actually work in three different ways. I'll show you once we've got the camera on. Now, I'll explain something here again. Before you turn this on, make sure you never turn it on without the camera being in the actual holder here, because it needs to be weighted for the gimbal to actually sort itself out and actually calibrate itself. So never turn it on without the camera being present, because it may again mess up the actual gimbal itself. Now, unlike other similar products on the market, some of them are very difficult to actually attach. You have to use a cable to actually strap around, and then it's hard to take off. This is very good, and one of the reasons I bought this one as opposed to anything else is you've simply got two screws that you lock down once the camera's in. So all you do is take the GoPro, this is the GoPro HD Hero 4, slot it in, do up both screws like that, and very simply you're ready to go. So at the moment, obviously the gimbal's not working. Now to turn it on, there's a button on the bottom which you just do, you push that down. Make sure you're as level as possible when you do it, just to give the stabilization a chance to really calibrate well. So you just turn it on, count to four, I think it is, two, three, four, and it will set itself. You saw there, it actually went straight into gimbal mode and we're ready to go now. So what I'm actually going to do here is set the camera running and show you the footage as we're actually playing with it. So it's just switching on now, and then we'll set that running. So you can see here, it's a pretty cool gimbal. Handle's pretty good, it's like brushed metal, so it feels good and solid. And we're currently in mode one. So if I show you the back of the gimbal, you can see it's flashing once. That means you're in mode one. Press it twice for mode two, then mode three, hold it down for mode three, but I'll go through those in a second. Mode one is probably my most used mode. because it's just the most versatile. You can see here we've got three axes. So first of all, we've got the up and down axis, and it's filming. I think we're still filming. Yeah, we're filming. So you've got the up and down axis there. So if you're running about, it's actually very, very stable indeed. Then you've got the side to side movement, and then you've got the twisting movement. Now with this particular movement, it's very ingenious as well. It's very clever because as I twist it and stop, the camera will slowly turn and then stop central. So if I turn around that way, again, the camera will turn around and stop. So it's very, very smooth movement. Very good. I've got some excellent footage from this so far. So really, you've got your arm as one stabilizing area, and then you've got the gimbal itself. So it's always good to hold it fairly out and let your arm do a lot of the work as well. And then you end up with some of the best footage you can possibly get. Really, really stable. Like I said, I've used this running after my kids on skateboards. We've used it in France quite a lot. I've used it for lots of selfies. It's great for selfies. So if you want to do a selfie of you and your family, then obviously you just turn it on yourself and you just talk away and say, hi, welcome. This is the Feiyu Tech gimbal, the G3 Ultra. And you can see as I move it around, it's still pretty stable. And you can do some great selfies. Now, another thing it's good for is if you go to concerts and you like to film bands, live music, that kind of thing, then it's good because you can just hold it dead still and you will get excellent footage. It'll look as though you've got the camera locked down on a tripod. It holds very, very still and it's always correcting itself. So even slight jolts and movements won't really show up. So it's a fantastic thing to take to concerts. One thing I will say, it's not waterproof. Obviously the camera's not in its housing when it's in the gimbal, so you have to be aware. If you're taking it skiing or snowboarding, be aware if you drop it, you're likely to get it all very wet. So just be careful and be aware that it's not waterproof. So that's mode one. It's pretty good, and it, like I say, it's the one I use the most for running about and following people, chasing people, my kids' sports, that kind of thing. To go to mode two, you just press this twice. And we're now in mode two. Now the only real difference between mode one and mode two is that when I then point this straight downwards, if you watch the camera, it will follow and stop. And then if we go upwards, it'll slowly follow through and go upwards. And if we go further, it'll go up. So it's good if you're going to film something over the edge of something and then bend it down, it will actually, rather than hold straight, it will actually go over and then slowly go down to look over the edge. So it's quite handy if, like I say, you're filming over cliffs or you're watching something, maybe someone diving off a cliff. You go over, film it like that, and then it would just follow them down. Real fluid, slow movement, and you've captured it pretty well. Third mode, if we just push it down and hold it, wherever you are, when you do that, whenever you can see now, we've actually got a blue light on there, so it's gone pure blue now. So the thing with mode three is, when you actually activate mode three, the camera will always face that exact direction. So you can see, no matter where I turn this now, it will always face wherever it was when I pressed mode three. Now you have to be very wary of this. If you're maybe on a bike following somebody and you're on a dead straight road, it's fantastic. Or if you're in a car going along a straight road, it's great. Or if you want to lock it on somebody, if you're filming somebody driving in a car, you want to absolutely lock it on them with no twisting movements or anything, then it's great for that. But what you don't want to be doing is put it in mode three when you're maybe skateboarding or running in opposite directions, doing 360 loops and things like that, because obviously when you turn this, it's going to get to a point where it's going to drag the camera and then it could mess up the motors, I suppose. So you don't really want to do that. You can see if I turn it now, it's going to go, but as soon as I go back, it will always go back to that heading. So no matter what I do with the camera, it's absolutely locked on that position. So you have to be a bit careful with it. So if I could press it once now, I'm now back on mode one, and it's my favorite mode again. So you've got three really good modes, depending on what you're filming. And you can see it's just really good fluid movement. You can see there if we're filming along and up, it's absolutely brilliant. So I love this. I think it's a great, great device. I've used it for filming my children quite a lot. I've used it on holiday quite a bit, and we've got some amazing footage. There's some of me in France running across rocks, really kind of steep, jagged rocks, whilst filming, and it just comes out so smooth. It's so great. Like I said, it's good for selfies. It's great for doing maybe stock footage if you're a stock videographer. You can get all sorts of great stuff from this. So totally recommend it. It's a lot of fun. And like I say, it's only about £210, so it's a great thing to add to your video arsenal. Now, before I go, I will just explain a couple of other things. So I'm going to actually switch it off now and switch the camera off. There are a couple of good accessories you can get for the GoPro and for the Feiyu Tech gimbal. One thing with the GoPro, if you are filming yourself, if you're out filming and you're narrating while you're filming, so you may be doing a selfie while you're somewhere, so you're saying, hi, welcome, we're here in blah, 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 then one thing it's worth getting for the GoPro is the actual adapter to put an external microphone in. Even though the microphones on the GoPro are very good, I would recommend getting one of these and then maybe a long lavalier microphone, so you can actually have it dangling down and up like this one here, so no one's going to see the microphone, but it just adds to the sound and you'll get less wind noise. The other thing for the gimbal is an extension pole. Now you can get as many of these as you want, they're really cool, but a couple of caveats with that. I think I'll just turn that on, put that down for a second. This basically extends the Feiyu Tech itself, so you have to be careful when taking this bottom bit off, the batteries don't fall out. You can see they're all in there, so you make sure they don't fall out and go running off somewhere. So when you take this, the switch on and off button out, then make sure you don't lose it. Then all you do is put this in. Another caveat. You don't just put this in and the batteries fall out. Right, so this is something I've kind of done before by mistake, is when you get this extension pole on the bottom, which you have to take off first, is another switch. It's another on-off switch. So what you have to do, that one's come out as well, is actually put this in first into the camera, sorry, into the handle, leaving the other one out, and then you attach this. Now, one kind of design flaw with this is that the button on the bottom, even if you put this on the bottom of here, it won't work to activate the camera. So what you've got to actually do is switch the camera on there, switch the gimbal on there, sorry, and then put this on. So it's very difficult to turn off. To turn it off now, I've got to actually unscrew it all and turn the gimbal off. But once it's on, it gives you a lot of extra reach, as you can see there. So if you're skiing or snowboarding or following someone on a mountain bike or chasing after people or doing an extended selfie, then obviously you can use this one. It's actually quite good. So it's pretty good. I've used it again for bikes and things. It gives you that bit of extra reach. And the longer it goes, the more kind of fluid movement you've got. Now, they say you can use two of these, so I could put another one on there and make it quite a long gimbal. So for concerts way above everybody's heads, it would look fantastic. But if you start to put too many on, then you're putting strain on the base bit here. So if you wanted to put 10 or 15 on and film the top of your house or something, then you're going to start to struggle and you could kind of maybe break the actual bottom bit here. But one or two of these, great if you're going to do, you know, if you want to, like I say, film lower down on the floor and run along somebody when they're skateboarding, then it's worth getting something like these. And again, these don't cost a lot of money either. They're just completely hollow, carbon fiber tubes. So yeah, they're pretty cool. I'd recommend those as well. But as far as the actual gimbal itself goes, I'm going to show you a little bit of footage now that I've taken with it. And you can see for yourself that it's actually pretty good, pretty stable. And it's a great complement to your GoPro.
To test this camera, I've come to Cannes.
Hi.
So here we are in Cannes. I've got the HD Hero 4 on 1080p, 60 frames a second, using the gimbal. It's pretty good, seems pretty stable. Seems to be working fairly well. Turn around into the sun. A lovely day. Just playing about with it, make sure it all works okay, as advertised. But you can see the beautiful yachts behind, the castle on the hill over there. Very nice indeed. Of course, only the best reviews on all things photography. Me on a bike, following a bike, riding one-handed, holding the gimbal, the GoPro 4, 1080p, 60 frames a second. Pretty good, felt good in the hand, it was quite easy to use while you're riding a bike, so yeah, it works pretty well. The Eiffel Tower, see it's behind us.
Going up it.